Hello everyone, and most welcome to this live broadcast in Ericsson headquarters in Stockholm, Sweden. Today we have some exciting news lined up for you, and we have a goldmine of experts to share more information about it. My name is Lena, and I will be your host today, but I'm not alone. I also have my co-host.
Yes, so will I, Sten Axelsson. Hi, everybody, and welcome. And we actually want you guys to engage from the very beginning into today's show. So we want you to comment and ask questions over social media channels, of course, but we also have a tool for you. So we would like you to go into menti.com, and you're going to need a code to respond, and you need 967034. So 967034, and you go into menti.com, and you answer our starting question. And we would like to know where you are you watching from. So that could be a country, could be a city, could be a special place, where you are right now. So we're going to have a look at your answers in a little while, all right? But Lena, you mentioned some news today.
Yes.
What are we unveiling?
Well, today it's all about cloud. We will have a closer look at how cloud infrastructure can be adapted to be used also in radio access networks. Because today we are introducing Cloud RAN by Ericsson. And you are welcome to join us on the journey.
All right, and let's have a look if we have any early results already now at the menti.com survey that we had. Yes, you are watching from...
We have very different origins of our journey ahead.
It's diverse.
We have Sweden.
USA.
Yes.
We have home.
Yeah, of course,
Japan,
a lot of people at home.
Ottawa. From YouTube. Excellent.
Bristol.
All
Germany,
over the world, really.
India. Canada.
You're joining us from different time zones. It's so great to see.
Definitely a global crowd that we have with us here today.
So with that, we tested. Now let's begin our journey. Take it away.
Yes. So hello, Cecilia. Great to have you here.
Hey, Lena.
So looking at this past year, I mean, we have had an enormous pickup and growth in 5G. But what is your view on what 5G provides today, but also what it can enable in the future?
Thank you, Lena. Well, first of all, it's amazing to see 5G really happening all over the world. Today, there are over 100 live commercial 5G networks. Ericsson is proud to be powering close to 70 of those across five continents. Among the early adopters, we see a large of uptake for data. The data consumption of 5G users is about 2 to 3 times of that of 4G users. Of course, a lot of video created, video consumed. And with that comes enhanced video services such as augmented reality, virtual reality. Home connectivity is, of course, super important in these days, also important for business, as well as 5G now starting to happening on a scale for industries and enterprise.
Sounds like networks are more important than ever before.
Well, indeed they are. Yeah. I mean, it's just looking at the current situation in the world, right? Without the connectivity among people, we wouldn't be able to meet. Even those of us who are able to meet are having to stand a bit away from each other. So I think that this global pandemic has also shown what a critical infrastructure the mobile networks actually are. And they are becoming more and more important as we add new functionality and use cases that they can enable.
Yeah, I think if it's anything we learned this year, it's that you never know what's around the corner, right?
That's right. So with this, I mean, networks still need to evolve, right?
Yeah.
So what we have done now in Ericsson is that we have put the best and the brightest mind together, really thinking about how would the networks for the future look like? What services would they enable? And how can we build the network so that they evolve over time? And this is what we're going to look into now. Right, Lena?
Yeah. It sounds like we are well prepared.
I think
indeed
we are.
And talking about the future, let's have a look at a short video clip with Fredrik Jädling, our head of business area networks, as he shares his view on future mobile networks.
We believe future networks will be high-performing, scalable, flexible, open for innovation. We are on a journey together with our customers and partners to explore what potential these networks have for the future. Part of this journey is Cloud RAN by Ericsson, a complement to our industry-leading purpose-built platform. We are introducing this flexible platform to address use cases such as enhanced mobile broadband, AI VR applications, industry applications, and ultimately a lot of cases that we probably haven't thought about yet. We have the best Cloud RAN in the world, and we look forward to exploring this together with you.
What an inspiring message. And before I turn to you, Cecilia, I actually have one more question to our audience. So now it's time to once again go to menti.com, enter the code 967034, or use the direct link that you can also find in the chat on the platform you're at. And now we want you to answer the question, what use case are you most excited about? What do you really want to see in the future? And while you answer that online, Cecilia, what's your reflections on what we heard Fredrik say in the video?
Well, I think when we talk about networks for the future, it's very clear that now is the right time to move forward and put a Cloud RAN, leading Cloud RAN solution to the market. It's going to add flexibility, and with that, not only in how we deploy the networks, but also paving the way for a whole lot of new use cases.
Yeah, you mentioned use cases, and I mean, in the video, we saw Fredrik in an exhibition, we saw him sitting in a car. How do you see Cloud RAN will enhance these situations?
So Cloud RAN has been built to both work in large scale deployments as well as in centralized locations. And with that, a better performance and use case scenarios for areas such as indoor, with enterprise and industries, and also, you know, moving into specific locations like stadiums, for example, to really boost the user experience and the network performance. Mm.
Great. Now I'm actually super curious what the audience has voted at as their favorite use case. What are you most excited about? Let's have a look at the answer. Okay, so I can see that there is a strong demand for AR and VR.
Exactly.
Is that surprising to you? Is that what you expected, Cecilia?
I'm not really surprised, given that that is the main case that has been launched and appreciated, for example, in South Korea, one of the most early and advanced markets. I also find it interesting to see that industry applications, there is a lot of ambition in that area too. So not only for the benefit of consumers, but also for business opportunities.
Thank you, Cecilia. By that, I think we are ready to dive into the technology and have a closer look at what Cloud RAN is and what is the journey ahead. So I suggest that we move over to Sten and Per.
Yes, all right, come on over. And let us try and figure out what lies ahead in terms of Cloud RAN. And we're going to do that together with Per Narvinger, who is the head of our networks portfolio at Ericsson. And that means he's the head of all the equipment that you see on the tower behind us here. So welcome, Per.
Thank you.
All right. And so just to begin with, based on what we heard Fredrik mention as well, why do networks need virtualization? And why do we need openness in order to boost 5G and get even more innovation, would you say?
So to start off, to comment also on what Cecilia said, that we have delivered on the promise of 5G. 5G networks are live, but the way we built them is according to what we call purpose-built principles. So we designed the hardware, and we designed the software, we integrate it tightly, and of course we optimize it to the lowest level. But this also means that the operational model of our networks becomes somewhat unique for our radio networks. And if we now move to virtualization, we can then have a common hardware with other domains and industries even. And we also get a common framework for how to orchestrate or run or operate the networks. So that is the promise of a virtualization for our industry.
Okay, that's virtualization. And then what does then Cloud RAN, also by Ericsson, mean in this context?
So Cloud RAN by Ericsson is then our virtualization effort of the radio access network. So we have taken all our domain expertise, built a brand new cloud native 5G stack, software stack, And then this one can then run on common off-the-shelf hardware. And today then, as I said, we have delivered networks typically with purpose-built hardware. So today we are in the Ericsson studio. And so there's a lot of equipment here. So we also take the opportunity to maybe have a look at what does it look like today out in a network. So a typical site might have a cabinet like the one next to me here. Of course, a lot of equipment in it. There's power, the batteries, fans. But in the middle here, and you can see a board here, and this is actually the compute part of the radio access network, and typically referred to as the baseband, or maybe the brain of the network. This is then what controls and connects to the other very important part of the network, being the radio units. And typically they sit up in a tower, maybe like the one here, or on a rooftop. And they, of course, our radios come in different shapes and forms. There might be the one more integrated ones or the passive ones with the radio unit further down. But those are the two key components. And then what we are doing by virtualization or Cloud RAN by Ericsson, that this unit then, the baseband, that has then been running on the Ericsson purpose-built hardware, will now be able to execute on COTS hardware, an x86 blade basically. And probably you might not even deploy in this way only. You could also have, if you have good transport or fiber, you could put it in a data center and have a really embrace the cloud paradigm, if I put it that way.
Right. And then why would we do it? Why do we do it? And which benefits do we see for our operators as well?
So we already started talking about the benefit of being able to orchestrate across maybe the core network, the transport network, and maybe even the applications that will be running on top of the networks. And that is one obvious benefit. The other thing, of course, when you build something purpose-built, there's a lot of focus on optimizing the performance and cost of the unit, the power consumption. I mean, you have this type of deployment here in a cabinet. Those are very important aspects. What probably is less important than, or what you pay less attention to, is the scalability. Of course, you can stack a few boards here, maybe put a router next to it. But if you think about in the cloud paradigm, you would actually then have a data center, and you have enormous potential to scale in and scale out. Think of a stadium event where a lot of people are one day, next day no people at all. So if you then scale up one day, you can use that hardware for something else the following day. So that is the opportunity with Cloud RAN by Ericsson.
Scalability, flexibility, and great opportunities ahead, really. Okay, thank you for that, Per. And now we are going to put you back at work. So you guys are going to get another question. And this time, we would like to ask you, what role, based on what you've heard now, what role do you think Cloud RAN will play for networks in the future? And you're going to get three alternatives. So A would be it's going to play a major role for networks in the future, Cloud RAN. And B would be it's going to be more a complement to existing infrastructure. And then C, it's going to play a minor role to the networks of the future. So while you let that simmer and you send in your answer, we should ask ourselves, how are we at Ericsson becoming cloud ready? And so to help us answer that, we're going to head over to Ottawa in Canada, where Eric Parsons is ready, because he is the head of the R&D center over there. So please, over to you, Eric.
Thank you very much, and hello from the other side of the Atlantic. We're here in our R&D facilities in Ottawa, one of several sites where Ericsson Cloud RAN portfolio is being developed, tested, and readied for launch. Cloud RAN will be designed and released in stages that are strategically aligned with the needs of our global customers. These are exciting new steps in the future architectures of networks and will allow customers to embrace more automation and capitalize on the tool sets that we see in cloud deployments in the core. The whole purpose as we progress is to enable innovation, and by having these steps, we will reach a more agile approach and create opportunity to shape RAN performance with information across domains and from external sources. As you can see, there's an exciting road ahead of us, and we're here to work with our customers every step of the way.
Thanks for those words, Eric. Okay, now let's look if you have put in some answers into Mentor.com on that question we asked. What role will Cloud RAN mean for networks of the future? Ah, okay, results are coming in. So complement to existing infrastructure, a slight lead over a major role. Okay, spontaneous comments, Per?
At least we are investing in something that is wanted right by the audience, because obviously we can dispute whether it will be complementing or this is where the industry is going all in, right? But for sure, there's interest for what we are launching today.
I think that's great to see. Okay, thanks for that. And now we are going to hand it over back to Lena and next guest Gabriel to figure out which exact components are we launching today, technically. Over you to Lena.
So listening to Eric and Per, it sounds like we have a well-planned and thought-through journey ahead of us. But now I think it's time to go into the details and have a closer look at what we are launching today. And who better to talk about that than our Cloud RAN expert, Gabriel Foglander. So welcome, Gabriel.
Thank you, Lena.
So what can you tell us about the offering that we are launching today?
Yeah, it is an exciting launch for us, certainly. So before we go into the specific of the products, I think there are some highlights to mention on the solution level. And the first one is that we are actually able to bring a system verified solution in this context. And that means that we can ensure that the cloud infrastructure and application can work very well together, both at day one, but also over the lifecycle. And we do that by deploying a cloud agnostic software on top of the cloud infrastructure. So that is a really important design consideration here, that we have that ability. And third, I think we can leverage greatly from the fantastic radio portfolio that we have with our colleagues here in the Ericsson radio system portfolio. And that gives us a tremendous advantage in able to deploy radios that meet the customer needs in different shapes and varieties of frequencies and bands and so forth. We also recognize that it is really important to be able to combine the existing deployments that we have in field with when we introduce a cloud RAN technology. And that we do by adding seamless interworking. And one example of that is that we actually managed to bring Ericsson spectrum sharing to work across the platforms of Ericsson Cloud RAN and their Ericsson radio system together. And finally, it's worth mentioning also that we build this to be cloud native from the start. And that will yield tremendous benefits, both in terms of efficiency and TCO as well, for our customers.
Great overview. But if we go into the details, I mean, what are the new products that we are adding to the Ericsson family today?
Yeah, that's a very nice way to put it. New members of the family.
Yes, so the dear ones.
We're welcoming today the Cloud RAN software component. So that consists of the Cloud RAN distributed unit, which we shorten Cloud RAN DU, and the Cloud RAN centralized unit, which we shorten Cloud RAN CU. And those two together, as Per explained, they deliver the functionality of the radio access network. On top of that, I mentioned also that we need to have an ability to provide access to radios, not only ones that we can sell today, but also the ones that we have installed in the field. And to do that, we introduce a radio gateway today. And that means that we can interconnect existing radios in the field to our Cloud RAN solution and make them work together. So that is a fantastic proposition. And altogether, we have that opportunity to have a cloud-native solution for low-band 5G.
And you mentioned low-band there. But what about other 5G-supported frequencies?
Yeah, that is a really great question, of course, because 5G needs to have, you know, the variety here. And we know that since that is important, we also accommodate support for the Cloud RAN CU to actually interwork with the ERS radio system portfolio and the baseband that we have in that place. So in that way, we can support both high band and mid band deployments with the CU today. And then we can extend also for further steps. So with the stage two that we believe we will have for our Cloud RAN portfolio will comprise mid band functionality as well as adding network automation features.
That makes sense. And also well aligned with the Ericsson spectrum sharing that usually runs over low band then.
Exactly. And that gives us the ability to combine the layers and extend the reach of mid-band deployments, which is a tremendous benefit for operators who are invested in that spectrum.
That is great, Gabriel. So now I think we have listened a lot to different experts here at Ericsson. And I think it's time to turn the ear to the outside world and hear some external voices. So let's head over to Sten and a guest analyst.
Yes, we are going back to the other side of the Atlantic to hear an external voice. So in California, we've got Joe Madden. welcome to the show. So,
thank you, Stan. I'm happy to be here.
Very nice to have you with us. So, can you tell me your area for mobile experts? Tell us a bit about that and your background in the area.
Okay, so I've been building radio equipment myself for mobile networks for more than 30 years, since the 80s. And I founded Mobile Experts 12 years ago to publish market research around base station deployment and to follow the technical trends in the RAN. About 5 years ago, I personally started doing some cost-benefit analysis on Cloud RAN to understand where would this be most useful in the network and what would the key technologies be to make Cloud RAN work.
All right. So from your expert perspective, what are your thoughts on Cloud RAN as a concept in general?
It's funny how this term has been polluted. It's been very confusing because many different companies use this word Cloud RAN for many different purposes. And you've seen many products, I think, over the last 4 years that have been launched with different meanings to the word Cloud RAN. So, you know, there's centralized RAN, coordinated RAN, now Cloud RAN. I think people are a little confused. But I see a lot of promise here, and I see this launch from Ericsson as being a really key part of bringing out the true economy of scale and virtualization that's needed, and also the openness that's going to bring in new business value.
All right. And so, having listened to the launch and the outline of it, how do you see, what are your reflections around, you know, Cloud RAN by Ericsson?
Well, I think it's a thoughtful approach to Cloud RAN, virtualization, and the rest. I'm impressed with the way that Ericsson has taken this idea of virtualizing the things that are non-real-time, virtualizing the DU and the CU, but then optimizing the things that are real-time. So that preserves the performance of all those radio features that Ericsson has worked so hard to develop over many years. But at the same time, opens up that economy of scale that I mentioned earlier for virtualizing the parts that can be virtualized the best. So I think it's a thoughtful balance between these two forces.
And on a different kind of scale, how do you see the differences between Open RAN and Cloud RAN from your perspective?
Well, yeah, it's funny, Sten, that these things have been conflated together, and some people think that Open RAN and Virtual RAN or Cloud RAN is really all the same. But in fact, I think it is important for operators to keep these as two separate dimensions and to make different decisions about Open RAN than they make about Cloud RAN or virtualization. In the case of Ericsson, what I see happening is you're launching virtualization in the non-real-time elements, the portion of the network that can be effectively virtualized from a technical point of view to get those benefits. And the openness is really geared toward building up new business opportunities. So starting at the top of the stack with openness in the RAN intelligent controller to allow new applications to come in and use the RAN for different purposes, things like network slicing and so on for private enterprise. So I think those are two different driving forces, and the decisions that come from those two forces are a little bit different. Ericsson has come up with a launch and a product line here that allows for those two things to be optimized separately.
Great. With that, Joe, I'd like to thank you for your insights and for joining us today.
Thank you. Take care, Stan.
Take care. Bye-bye.
And now I'm standing here with all of our Ericsson experts, so Cecilia, Gabriel, Per. And what are your reflections on the comments we had from Joe Madden? Do you agree with what he's saying?
Well, I think, first of all, I think he recognizes the confusion that to some extent has been happening in our industry over all these different Cloud RAN solutions and the Open RAN discussion. I think it's great to see how he recognizes the Ericsson Cloud RAN as an opportunity to really build scale. And also as it paves the way for openness, laying that foundation of virtualization for future networks.
Good point. Do you agree?
I have to comment also on the real-time aspect, because that is what has been a challenge for our industry, of course, or for radio access networks. They are real-time in nature. The compute is real-time. The radios are real-time. And of course, to make that happen then in a virtualized environment, that is the challenge, and that is what we are now overcoming. So I think a major milestone, as he's saying.
I agree. And now I think it's time to open up the questions from the audience. And I can see already here that there's several questions in the chat, but please keep them coming. We love to hear what's on top of your mind. So now let me start here. Cecilia, you and I, we were discussing when we asked the audience to say which use cases they were most excited about. Now we have a question from Jennifer on Facebook. So what is your favorite case?
Okay, hello Jennifer from Facebook. Well, I think since long I've been fascinated by Star Trek, I have to say. So the holodeck and the holograms that they were foreseeing in Star Trek. But now I think we could put it into another context. I mean, at this point in time, we cannot really be close to the ones we want sometimes. Dear ones to us, business connections, they are far away. Imagine if we could get those holograms working. I would love that.
Great. Then we have a question to you, Per, I think, from Beverly. So she is on Twitter and she's asking, so you have talked a lot about Open RAN and Cloud RAN today, but what about O-RAN?
So thank you from Twitter and that question. It's a good question because we get it a lot. And the way we define Open RAN is the hardware and the software disaggregation. It is a major step. That means that you can have one provider of the hardware, the cloud infra, and someone else then building the software on top of it. So that is Open RAN for us. And I think that's how most people in the industry refer to it as well. Then O-RAN is another step, if you put it that way, will defining even further with many new interfaces and then making sure that they work across different vendors. But what we are launching today is an Open RAN solution, and that is the Cloud RAN by Ericsson.
Good answer. So we also have a question here from Sarah on LinkedIn. And I think it's a good question to you, Gabriel. So will you only offer system verified solutions?
Okay, yeah. Hi, Sarah. Yeah, let me try to answer that. So as I mentioned, we do deploy cloud agnostic software, and that means that we have a possibility to deploy on a multitude of cloud infrastructure environment. However, what we learned in the virtualization journey of the core is that it's quite efficient to be able to provide the system verified approach, because then you can combine that the cloud infrastructure and the application works well together, and that you can have predictable results. And then you can also manage the lifecycle aspect of making that work over time, which is not trivial. However, we also recognize that many operators, of course, they have made their choice already today on cloud infrastructure. And that means that they have an existing platform. And since we then have cloud agnostic software, that puts us in a position to be able to deploy onto that as well. However, with a slightly different business model. So that is how we will approach that.
Good. And now that you've warmed up here, Gabriel, I have another question to you. It's from Christopher and he's on Periscope. And the question is, how is power consumption and heat generations compared to previous generations?
So, hi, Christopher. Depending on how you look at it, I mean, I think we have seen, and that is part of the reason why we have the timing of this launch, that for the COTS hardware itself, in order to accommodate the radio access network functionality that we have discussed, has improved quite a lot. However, as Per mentioned before, if you look at the kind of the benefits of a purpose-built networks, that's where you see one area where energy efficiency has been quite a tremendous advantage of purpose-built networks. And that is something I think we foresee for some time ahead as well.
Great. And you seem to be a popular person, Gabriel. Everyone wants to dive into the deep technology here. We have from LinkedIn, clearly many agree that the tech can heavily complement existing infrastructure. But what are other good business cases to make new investments into Cloud RAN and maybe a 5G-based Cloud RAN?
Yeah, I think we touched upon that question also a little bit with Cecilia mentioning some of the deployment scenarios that we put forth. Personally, I'm very excited about the industry angle as well, so I have to bring that up. Before I joined Ericsson, I worked in multinationals in different industry contexts. So I do think that we can see a lot of benefits coming into that context. When you combine connectivity tailored to the specific needs of those use cases and increase the productivity across many industry verticals, personally, I think that's a really interesting area. And I see also one where a lot of the industry is moving and trying to realize that promise and potential.
Okay, so another question. It's also technology related, but I mean, you are welcome to answer as well, Cecilia and Per. Let's see what you think. It's a question from Radio on LinkedIn. So he's asking, what is the impact on latency?
Well, I'll start off and then maybe Gabriel can jump in here. So that is a challenge, of course, to build real-time systems, as we discussed. And of course, what kind of latency do you get in the system when building it? We don't see limitations right now. We believe the technology is there also for CODs. But of course, it's going to be a journey, and we're going to see how far we can take it. I don't know, Gabriel, if you want to add more on it.
No, and I think maybe it's fair to also reflect on the fact that we have been on the 5G journey on the purpose-built track for a little bit longer. So I think, I mean, those kind of those kind of low-latency applications maybe are a little bit further ahead at this point. But like you say, the promise is there, and I don't think there's anything stopping us.
Mm. Ultra-reliable, low-latency cases.
There you go.
You go with them too.
Yes.
Over time.
And actually, there has been a lot of questions regarding latency, so good that you clarified that. So now we have a question from Josh from YouTube. So is Cloud RAN useful for distributed RAN case?
I'll start off on that one as well. Yeah. So you could. I think it depends on where you put... what is the special location of the unit that you want to put out there? In a cabinet, you could for sure put also COTS hardware there. But and maybe if you start seeing more of an edge application where you try to distribute your network and have the same environment everywhere, then that you would see it also in those kind of environments. But otherwise, you probably would expect it to start maybe more with an enterprise, an indoor case, or if you have a lot of compute need in one location, basically. I think that was probably the more obvious ones. And that's also why we say these solutions, they complement each other. We don't think one will take over the other one completely, but they will coexist for many, many years. And then I think different customers will make different choices. So that's the way we see it.
Good. Now we have a question from LinkedIn. So if a company that built complementing technology wants to join your ecosystem, how could they apply?
Well, I think we can start off by saying that as the industry evolves, it's very clear that ecosystem collaboration will be very needed. And of course, at this point in time, when we're launching this solution, we have ensured that it's system verified and working with Intel. So that's just one case. But now we're talking about wider evolution than just the hardware and software disaggregation. And as a partner to Ericsson, I think you can be sure to join us on a stepwise journey where we will invite a few select of you into our labs and to co-develop the solutions for the future together. So feel free to come back to us and we will look into how we can widen the ecosystem together.
Yeah, so get in touch. Then we have a question from Iqbal on YouTube. So does Ericsson Cloud RAN support existing Gs, so 2, 3, 4, or is it only for 5G and beyond?
So what we have started with is a 5G product now. As Gabriel was saying, we're launching a 5G low band initially, and then we see we're going to be adding more over time. And I think we will see how the future develops. I mean, obviously, we see that the solutions will coexist, and there are already excellent 2G, 3G, 4G networks out there. So we will now complement them with the Cloud RAN 5G solution as well. Then we'll see what demand is there in the future, how quick will this journey be. It's been actually quite a long journey on the core network side. So I think what is important here is that we see the technology becoming mature enough to start and seriously embark on it. Then we'll see at what pace it develops.
Good. I would like to thank you for answering all these great questions from our audience. But now we are approaching the end of the broadcast. But before we say goodbye, I would actually like you experts to join me here on, let me introduce, ta-da, the hot seat. And yes, it's smoking hot today. So I will ask our experts to have 10 seconds, it's not a lot of time, but in 10 seconds, you are to convey your main messages to the audience so that they know what to take away from this session here today. And I suggest we start with the ladies. So Cecilia, please join me on the hot chair. Don't burn yourself. Okay, good. So are you ready, Cecilia?
I am ready.
Then I want you to look into the camera over there. And give your pitch. Go.
So 5G is here. It's happening all over the world. And it's a platform for great innovation. And now is the time to complement those purpose-built solutions with Cloud RAN to build networks for the future.
Great. Thank you, Cecilia.
Thank
Next
you.
Person, come on here. Per, are you comfortable?
Very.
Yes, it's a bit short for you, but I think it's okay.
It's fine.
Okay, are you ready?
I'm ready to go.
Okay, go ahead.
So we have reached a major milestone. We have taken all our RAN domain expertise, built a new cloud-native 5G stack, and that is Cloud RAN by Ericsson.
Great, very short and concise, to the point. Gabriel, come on here. Join me on the hot chair.
Thank you.
You know what to do. You've seen the drill.
I know how it works now.
Okay, yeah. Just go ahead.
Yes, so stage one of our Cloud RAN portfolio includes the Cloud RAN DU, Cloud RAN CU, and a radio gateway. And this is our first step on a journey to provide leading Cloud RAN networks to our customers.
Great. Very good. Thank you, Gabriel. Thank you, Cecilia. Thank you, Per. I think you did a splendid job with concluding the session. And I think it was a good summary of what we have been discussing here today.
Excellent summary.
And for me, it was a pleasure to join you here today to talk about this exciting launch. And should you want to read more about it, you can go to our Cloud RAN page on ericsson.com.
So many great questions today, I have to say. But so you seem to be curious. If you want to read even more and watch even more about Cloud RAN, you should go into ericsson.com/techunveiled, one word. And there you got video clips and also blogs, so you can read up all you want on our launch today.
Yeah, and maybe I should also say that our experts, they are continuing answering questions online as well. So please stay tuned with the channel you're on. But now I just want to thank you all for watching this live broadcast from Ericsson headquarters. Thank you.
Thank you.
And we hope to see you soon. Bye.
Bye-bye.